Let's say questions on this. NCRT question.
So is it I plus 2J minus 3K or plus 3K?
Yeah, let me clarify that. That's plus 3K. Let me write it again for you. This entire stuff I'm writing again down here. R dot I plus 2J plus 3K minus 4 equal to 0. And this one is R dot 5I plus 3J minus 6K plus 8 equal to 0. Lately, I've seen CAM scanner, they start putting their logo unnecessarily. Earlier, they were not like this. Now they have unnecessarily started branding it. Again, don't give me lambda and all. Just give me the final answer, because that lambda will vary depending upon which equation are you keeping first. In fact, they will be reciprocals of each other. Now, since you're asking, Shreya, yes, your lambda is correct. I know that's not a very nice number to see, but yeah, that's correct.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
But can you finally give me the answer?
Yeah, I'm doing that, sir.
Done? If you're done, please feel free to type the answer and just privately message it to me. That's correct, Shreya. That's correct. Nobody else? Okay, so first you'll say that the equation of the desired family member can be written as R dot I plus 2J plus 3K minus 4 plus lambda times R dot 2I plus J minus K plus 5. Okay. Now, this is not a nice way to represent it. Let's represent this finally as some R dot N plus D equal to 0 form. That would make more sense. So for that, you have to take R common. So R dot, in fact, you have to apply opposite of the distributive property. So R dot, this plus this will give you, I'm directly writing the result, 2 lambda plus 1 I, okay? Lambda plus 2 J. And minus lambda plus 3k. Okay. And you'll have minus 4 plus 5 lambda equal to 0. Is that fine, everyone? Okay. Now, this vector is perpendicular to this vector. So, this vector is perpendicular to 5i plus 3j minus 6k. Right? This is just another way to find out the value of lambda. See, it's not necessary that always a point will be mentioned, right? You can find the lambda through various conditions which has been provided in the question. So here they gave perpendicularity to a certain plane. In some question, they will give you that this plane is at a certain distance from the origin, right? So there can be so many conditions cited which will enable you to find the value of lambda. So we'll have to practice all types of those questions. So if they are perpendicular, can I say 5, 2 lambda plus 1, 3 lambda plus 2, and minus 6 minus lambda plus 3 should be 0, correct? So 10, 13, 19 lambda, and you'll have 5 plus 6, 11, 11 minus 18 is minus 7. So lambda is going to be 7 by 19. Now please note, if somebody had taken lambda with the first equation, he would have got the answer as exactly reciprocal of this, that is 19 by 7. So don't try to match the lambda. In fact, if the lambda of two people are same, okay, and if they're reciprocal, then you both are on the right track or both are on the wrong track, okay. So either the lambda would be same or the lambda would be reciprocals, okay. Now, having got that, all you need to do was to put this in your equation of the plane back. That is at this step. So let me put 7 by 19 there. So it becomes R dot 2 lambda plus 1 give you 14 plus 1, 33 by 19 I. Lambda plus 2 will give you 38 plus 7, 45 by 19 J. Correct? Hope I have done the addition correct. 38 plus 7, 45. Yes. Yeah. And then if you put over here, that's 3 minus 57 minus 7 is 50k by 19. And here I will have minus 41 by 19. If you want, you can drop the 19 from everywhere and you can end up writing r dot 33i plus 45j plus 50k minus 41 equal to 0. Or you can write this in a Cartesian form as 33x plus 45y plus 50z equal to 41. Now, may I know the reason why you people could not solve this other than Shreya? What was stopping you from solving this?
So I didn't simplify it like how you did, like 2 lambda plus 1 and then do it.
Oh, so how would, if you don't simplify that, you will not be able to know the collective normal vector for this entire family member, right? So you have to consolidate like this. This is an important step. So yeah, Aditya, you have to consolidate your family of plane like this and then use it for whatever purpose is been used for. So let's say you have been given a point, then you can put a point in place of R. If you have been given, this is perpendicular to something, then you can do dot product of this with the given vector as zero, just like I did it in the present example. Getting my point? Let's say I had the question mean, the distance of this plane from origin is one. Then how do I do this? Let's say the second condition is, this condition I drop, which is perpendicular to the plane. I cut this and make it, it is at a unit distance from the origin. Then how do I do this? How do I get lambda in that scenario?
Make it as direction cosines over there and then the constant term equated to 1.
Right. So, or you can do one thing. We already know that in case of any equation of a plane, mod d by under root of a square plus b square plus c square represents the distance from the origin, right? So here your d is 5 lambda minus 4, isn't it? So 5 lambda minus 4 is your d and these are your ABCs. So all you need to do here was do 5 lambda minus 4 by under root of 2 lambda plus 1 the whole square, lambda plus 2 the whole square, minus lambda plus 3 the whole square equal to 1. Okay. Take it to the right side, square both the sides, find the lambda values. 2 value of lambda will come out because it will signify there are two possible planes at a unit distance from the origin. One is on this side of the origin, other will be on this side of the origin. Correct? So these are the different questions that can be framed. Are you getting my point? I'm not solving it. I'm just giving you an idea how to work with it. Is that clear, everyone? Family of planes is one of the most important concepts. Please type clear, else I will not move on.
Clear, sir, clear.
It's clear. Now I'll go back to the same old question, guys. So I'll just pull out that question and we'll solve the same question. I think this was the question. Yeah, question number 3.54. Now you would see how easily I can solve this question if I know my concept of family of planes. See, all of you, please see here. I have to find the equation of, I have to find the point of intersection of the line, this, with the intersection of these two, right? Now, what I'll say is that there's a line which is made up of the two planes which are themselves the family members. So what I'll do is, I'll say, let my line be represented in asymmetric form like this. So what did I do? I made a family of planes with these two planes. Correct? Okay. And again, I'll make a family from these two. So x plus y minus 2 plus some mu times x plus z minus 2 equal to 0. So the line which I am looking for is basically intersecting this line. Are you getting my point? So what I did, I'm again repeating it. These two planes, I made a family of planes with this. So this is my first family. This is my second family. Okay. So this plane is a family member of the first two, and the second plane is a family member of the later two equations. Correct. Now what I'm naming is that my line is in asymmetric form can be written like this. Do you agree with me or not?
Agreed, sir.
Okay. Now, in order to find lambda and mu, I can use this condition that this line is passing through 0, 0, 1. So when you put 0, 0, 1 over here, I think this will become completely 0. And if this becomes completely 0, there is no point evaluating this. This will also become, okay, whatever is it. So lambda has to be 0. Okay. Put 0, 0, 1 in the second equation. Right? Because this line is passing through 0, 0, 1, right? So both these planes must be satisfied by this line, isn't it? Because this line lies on both these planes. And both these planes themselves are family members. Okay? So here if you put, you get 0, 0, minus 2 plus mu times 0, 1, minus 2 equal to 0. So that becomes mu as 2. I'm sorry, minus 2. Correct? Yes or no? Now, when you put this value back, when you put this value back here and back here, you actually get the equation of the line in asymmetric form. That is x plus 2y plus z minus 1 equal to 0. And here when you put, you get x plus y minus 2 minus 2x plus z minus 2 equal to 0. That's nothing but minus x plus y minus 2z plus 2 equal to 0. Yes or no? Yes or no? Now, in these two equations, you want to know this. Basically, this line is passing through these two planes. That is what I'm trying to say. In other words, my required line has an asymmetric form of this x plus 2y plus z minus 1 equal to 0 and minus x plus y minus 2z plus 2 equal to 0. Now you want to know from where does this line, or where does this line meet the xy plane? So put z as 0. So when you put z as 0, you get x plus 2y is equal to 1 and minus x plus y is equal to minus 2. Okay. So add it. So 3y is minus 1. So y is minus 1 by 3. Put it over here. So x is equal to 1 minus 2y. That is 1 plus 2 by 3. That is 5 by 3. So the point of intersection is 5 by 3 minus 1 by 3, 0. See, we got the answer in a much faster way. I don't have to write too many things. Isn't it? Much easier way to do it. Is that clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please let me know if you have any questions with respect to this. Fine. If you have no question, we'll move on to the next concept. Fine. So now we'll take some generic question regarding angles. So let me take this question. We'll take few questions and then I'll start with the concept of angle between a line and a plane. Yeah, here goes the question. Find the equation of a plane containing this line and this point. Yeah. And I don't have much concepts left. Probably I'll talk about equation between angle between a line and a plane. Then I will talk about the distance of a point from a plane, distance between two planes. And one more concept is equation of bisector of planes. So I think I should be able to finish it off by 12:30 or so. Online classes are generally faster. Hope you can read this point. This is 0, 7, minus 7. Find the equation of a plane containing this line. That means this line is lying on the plane. something like this. And there's a point 07 minus 7. Please send the answer to me privately on the chat, or you can WhatsApp it to me. So this question belongs to the interaction of a plane and a line together. So we have done line and plane now to a considerable extent. So now we are trying to solve questions where there's a combination of these concepts coming up. Any idea how to do this?
So 1 minute to analyze.
Guys, please do attend problem solving classes also, because as I told you, 60%, 70% of your learning will come through problem solving. Right? Don't think like the theory is over, so you need not attend the classes. In physics, I have been getting the complaint that people are not attending because the theory has been completed. It's ultimately the problem that you have to solve. So that is more important class for you. Your theory will become more refined once you start solving problems based on those theories. Okay, see here. Once you have been given the equation of a line, basically two information is given to us. One is you know a point on this line. As you can see, minus 1, 3, minus 2 is a point on this line. Correct? And you have been given a vector in the direction of the line, and that vector has direction ratios of minus 3, 2, and 1. Correct? Now, how do I get the equation of this plane pi from here? Now, very simple. If I know this direction, can I also get this direction by connecting these two points? Okay, let me call this as b1 vector and let me call this as b2 vector. So who will tell me the direction ratios of b2 vector? Is the difference of the coordinates of these points? So let's subtract. So it's 1, 4 and minus 5. Any questions with respect to getting direction ratios of b2 vector? This is the direction ratios of b1 vector. Any doubts so far? Now, once you know two vectors on the plane, you can get the direction of the normal to the plane by taking the cross product of these two given vectors. Again, the basic concepts should not be forgotten. To get the equation of a plane, I need the normal and I need a point. Now, there's no dearth of the points here. Two points have been given to us directly or indirectly. Just I needed was the normal vector. So for normal vector, I would need the cross product of the two vectors, which are already lying in the plane of the vector, in the plane of that particular plane. So here I will get I, J, K. B1 components are 1, 4, negative 5. And this is minus 3, 2, 1. Okay, so let me just expand this vector. So it becomes 4 plus 10, 14, minus J, again a minus 14, okay, and K, oh my God, K is also plus 14. Wow, so 14i, 14j, 14k. Can I drop the factor of 14? I can. Even if you don't want to drop, it's fine. But I don't want to deal with these heavy numbers, 14, 14, 14. So what I'll do, I just need a vector in the direction of, you know, B1 cross B2. It can be any vector. I can keep it as simple as this. So I'll call this as my n. Okay. Now, I will use the formula R minus A, or you can use your directly Cartesian form since things are given in Cartesian form. So AX minus X1, BY minus Y1, CZ minus Z1 is equal to 0. Cool. So your A is 1. See, this is your A component, B and C. Okay. So 1. Take any one of the points. You can take the point on the line also. You can take the point given to you also. So let me take X minus 0. B is also 1. Y minus 7. C is also 1. Z plus 7. Okay. Expand it. It becomes X plus Y plus Z. I think there will be no constant left. So this is going to be your answer. Okay, so you should know how to deal with these situations.